Good morning. Can Moab escape judgment? Our reading today takes us to chapter 48 of the book of Jeremiah, and we're going to look at verses 1 to 10. Against Moab. Thus says the Lord of hosts, the God of Israel, Woe to Nebo, for it is plundered. Kirjathaim is shamed and taken. The high stronghold is shamed and dismayed. No more praise of Moab. In Heshbon they have devised evil against her. Come and let us cut her off as a nation. You also shall be cut down, O Madmen. The sword shall pursue you. A voice crying shall be from Horonaim, plundering and great destruction. Moab is destroyed. Her little ones have caused a cry to be heard. For in the ascent of Luhith they ascend with continual weeping. For in the descent of Horonaim the enemies have heard a cry of destruction. Flee, save your lives, and be like the juniper in the wilderness. For because you have trusted in your works and your treasures, you also shall be taken, and Chemosh shall go forth into captivity, his priests and his princes together. And the plunderer shall come against every city, no one shall escape. The valley also shall perish, and the plain shall be destroyed, as the Lord has spoken. Give wings to Moab, that she may flee and get away, for her cities shall be desolate, without any to dwell in them. Cursed is he who does the work of the Lord deceitfully, and cursed is he who keeps back his sword from blood. So all of chapter 48 of the book of Jeremiah is taken up and consists of judgments against Moab. So where is Moab? Well, you have the Sea of Galilee and then the River Jordan going through, and then at the south you have this larger body, the Dead Sea. And to the immediate east of the Dead Sea, that area is Moab. It's marked by a strong north-south mountain range, elevated way high as a plateau there on the east side going out to the Arabian Desert. So whereas the kingdom of Israel, the 10 northern tribes, and the kingdom of Judah, the 2 southern tribes, had been subject to many invasions over the years and different carryings away into captivity and things, didn't really ever happen to Moab. Moab just sort of stood off there on the side and said, boy, we're pretty clever up here. And Moab never really got carried away. That led to some interesting experiences between them and Israel. They were sort of enemies of Israel a lot of the time. So while all this action was happening across the way in Jerusalem and in the Hebrew lands, the Moabites were sort of a backwater, a pretty dry one, actually. Another thing we'll see as we go through this chapter, many of the cities that are mentioned, it looks like a lot of the more northern area of Moab especially seems to be centered where God's anger is, which is where, what would you think would happen? Well, as the Babylonian armies invaded the kingdom of Judah from the north, the inhabitants of the kingdom of Judah, they didn't want to be carried away into Babylon or maybe killed right and left. So what did they do? Surely many of them fled to the rocks and the crevices and the cracks and the far wilderness sagebrush areas there in Moab to try to get away and flee from God's chastening, because, you know, God allowed the kingdom of Babylon to come and its army to come and take them away. A lot of this judgment against Moab, some of it seems to be directed at that. Now, here's another thing that's interesting. While the Moabites maybe felt like we're going to escape this like we always have escaped it in the past, you know, God's going to take care of the big boys and we're going to be left alone, you know, Babylon and Egypt and the others. Isn't it true that we all live in a moral universe? And so what do you have going on here? God is keeping everyone accountable in every space. And whereas these neighbors of Israel should have helped God's people, they were very aloof and not very helpful at all. In fact, they were positively hostile toward Israel most of the time. It's interesting here what's going on. Maybe they think they'll escape it, but chapter 48 shows us for just about 50 verses worth, they're not going to be escaping their accountability at all. In fact, it's dangerous to watch smirking from the sidelines as God chastens his people, and you're not one of his people. It's pretty dangerous to take that line. Our Father in heaven is looking for the right spirit in every place, and he wants to help all of us experience the right spirit. Let's pray. Dear Father in heaven, we want to be in your will. We want to be not prideful, not lifted up high, not needing to be chastened, but, Lord, to be ready to follow along wherever you lead us. Lord, help us to have a humility. Help us to realize, too, that you are in every place. We are accountable in every place. There's no place where we can hide in the corners and judgment, accountability, morality will pass us by. Help us to be in the right place morally where you'd have us to be. Thank you for hearing our prayer this morning. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. So it's true, none can escape judgment, not even clever Moab. God be with you today.